year was 1980. The place, Brooklyn, New York. Bushwick, to be exact. Considered to be one of America's most dangerous ghettos, it was a place you pray you never get lost in. Crime was soaring, bloodshed was commonplace, and bullets had no name. While all across America mothers gently tucked their children into bed, it was the sounds of gunshots and sirens that were Bushwick's bedtime story. If you were to take a walk down these poverty-stricken streets, if you would listen in the still of the night, you would hear the voices of a generation on the verge of being lost. They would be lost because in order to find them, you must come here. But who? Who would brave these streets? And even if they dare, who could possibly convince a child of the ghetto that they could be anything more than what these streets had destined them to be? Could anyone look into the eyes of such and actually see hope? Enter Bill Wilson, a child of the same fate. Abandoned by his own mother, Bill knew what it was to be hungry, rejected, and passed by. And so he set out on a mission to see just how much of an impact one man could have in the lives of those who had nobody. And so was born Metro Ministries, a haven for those whose shoulders were heavy with the burdens of life. Children who came to Metro found a place where they were allowed to be just that, children. It was a place of excitement and fun, and most of all, safety. There was no fear, only love, smiles, hugs, and people who saw something in them that a mirror could never reveal. Bill came to New York alone, but he wasn't alone for long. His vision quickly spread, and soon he was joined by men and women from all over the world who left all behind and came to stand with him. Realizing that in order to reach anyone, you must understand their struggles, they would choose to live among the people, just as Bill had done from the beginning. 25 years later, the vision remains the same. Metro Ministry still stands, reaching well over 20,000 children and families every week. They offer feeding programs, school supply programs, job opportunities, counseling, summer camps, sponsorship, English and Spanish church services, and most of all, a positive message of hope and unconditional love. During Christmas, Metro gives away over 40,000 wrapped gifts. For many children, it is their only gift. If you ask the staff what is the key to their success, they will tell you that what makes it work is that every child is visited by a staff member weekly, regardless of where they may live. Though he's been robbed, beaten, stabbed, and shot, Bill Wilson remains in Bushwick leading the 150 staff members and 300 volunteers in their mission. Every weekend, he travels the world trying to raise enough money to keep the ministry afloat. Battling both disaster and disease, Bill and his staff refuse to be intimidated by any obstacle. The latest obstacle? How do we avoid turning away people in desperate need? The new ministry complex, Metro World Ministry Center, a full city block that will enable Metro Ministries to begin community outreach programs as well as house the expanding international ministry headquarters. This is not just an expansion. It is an investment in children here in New York, across America, and around the world. This is the Sunday school the world is building,